Hello students and other followers of my YouTube channel. My name is Lemana Hapte. In our previous presentation, we have covered Unit 1, introduction about laboratory and laboratory equipment. Today we are going to start Unit 2, hematology and hematological test. This is lesson 1. Under this lesson, we have prepared objective or design objective. At the end of this lesson, students are expected to define hematology, describe difference between serum and plasma, explain the importance of venous and capillary blood collection, explain the appropriate sample for hematological tests. When we try to define hematology, hematology is constructed from two words, hema and logy. Hema means blood, logy is study. Simply, hematology is the study of blood. This is also another definition. Hematology is the study of the cells that are found in blood and the factors that affect their functioning. Blood is a circulating blood fluid composed of liquid and solid portion. The liquid portion is plasma, whereas the solid portion is blood cells. Cells or formal elements constitute about 45% of blood volume. These are white blood cells or leukocytes, red blood cell or erythrocytes, platelets or thrombocytes. By the way, blood cells are formed in the womb after conception within 14 to 20 days by the process of hematopoiesis or hemopoiesis. This means hematopoiesis or hemopoiesis is a process of blood cell formation. Liquid portion of blood comprise or constitute 55% of blood volume. What is the difference between serum and plasma? When blood is collected in a plain tube means a tube without anticoagulant, it solidifies within 5 to 10 minutes or become clot. When this clot blood is centrifuged, the upper portion becomes serum, the lower portion becomes clot or red mass of the cells. Why does blood clot outside the blood vessel but liquid in the vessel? Please try this by your own. In other ways, if blood is collected into a tube containing an anticoagulant, clotting is prevented and the blood becomes whole blood. By this, when we are inverting the tube, it becomes whole blood or the cells are suspended in the plasma. When blood treated with anticoagulant or a blood containing or mixed with anticoagulant is centrifuged, the upper portion becomes plasma and the lower portion becomes blood cells. Difference between plasma and serum. Plasma is liquid portion of whole blood. In addition to this, it contains soluble protein or fibrinogen in addition to large number of other proteins. Serum is liquid portion of clotted blood, but it does not contain fibrinogen. This is because fibrinogen is consumed during blood clotting. Generally, these are the differences between serum and plasma. By the way, whole blood is the appropriate blood sample for hematological test. If we went to collect blood for hematology, the tube must contain anticoagulant. Here are examples of plasma and serum. When blood is collected in this kind of tube, or with blue stopper tube, the blood becomes whole blood. During centrifugation, it makes three layers. The upper layer, plasma, the middle, puffy coat, which contains white blood cell and platelet. The lower layer becomes red blood cell. Or in other words, when blood is collected into red stopper tube or yellow stopper tube, which is plain tube, the blood will clot. During centrifugation, the upper portion becomes serum, the lower becomes mass of red blood cells or other cells. Here are examples of tubes in the laboratory. Yellow stopper tubes, most of the time or always, they are plain tube. Blue stopper tubes contain anticoagulant like EDTA. So for hematology test, blood should be collected into blue stopper tube. What are anticoagulants? Anticoagulants are chemical substances which prevent blood from clotting. There are different examples, types of anticoagulant. Example, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid or EDTA, sodium citrate, heparin, and oxalates. The anticoagulants are used depending on the type or the purpose of the test. Collection of blood sample. Blood can be collected from veins and capillary according to the amount of the blood volume. Capillary blood may be collected from finger, the earlobe, or the heel in infants. Venous blood is collected from the vein using syringe and needle. Skin puncture or capillary blood collection is collected when the test requires a small amount of blood, for example, to determine blood glucose, like RBS, random blood sugar, fasting blood sugar, rapid HIV testing, blood smear, and other tests which need a small amount of blood. We collect blood from a capillary or skin puncture. It is also used when vein puncture is impractical, like in a neonate, in case of severe burn, we have to collect blood from a capillary puncture. In patients whose arm veins are used for medication, IV medication, we have to use skin puncture. Sites of skin puncture in adults, either the tip of ring or middle finger, lobe of earlobe of the person if the fingers are not comfortable or deformed, we collect from its lobe. In infants, big toe, the heel are the appropriate site of capillary blood collection. Procedure materials like alcohol swab, dry cotton, lancet, sterile lancet, sample container like capillary tubes, slides, and other materials are used to receive blood from the skin. After assembling the required material by cleaning the skin with 70% alcohol swab, we puncture after the skin is dried using a sterile lancet. This is a procedure. We wipe the first drop. This is because the first drop can contain tissue juice, which can interfere with the test result. Take the appropriate amount of blood At the end, we apply dry cotton to stop bleeding. There is a procedure after the skin is cleaned with alcohol swab, not the tip, but to the side of the finger. We puncture with automatic or other type of lancet by positioning the hand of the palm up. After puncturing, we remove the first drop and we collect blood sample using different materials. Here is how to collect blood from the infant heel using capillary tube. This is a capillary tube. We hold it horizontally and after puncturing the skin, we collect the blood like this. By this, we have completed today's presentation. Next, we will discuss about venous blood collection. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.